Recently, we took a look at the performance of the AMD Wraith coolers with Ryzen in anticipation for this video, which is centered around hopefully helping you to decide on a cooling solution for your Ryzen CPU. We did partner up with AMD and Cooler Master to be able to bring you this, where we explore several different cooling options ranging from a $35 tower air cooler to a $90 240mm AIO. As far as the cooler lineup goes, we've got the ever popular Cooler Master Hyper 212 Evo coming in at the budget friendly price of $35, and while it's not the fanciest of coolers, you'll see soon why it's still so popular. And moving up from there, we have the MasterAir Pro 4, which is similar to the Hyper 212 in size and installation, but features a new heat fan design along with the MasterFan 120 balance fans, as well as a black finished top to complement its more premium $45 price tag. Both install the same way, and it's a bit cumbersome, but once on, it's not going anywhere. Bringing up the price a bit to $60 gets you into the MasterLiquid series with the MasterLiquid 120. Featuring a single 120mm size radiator and a pair of MasterFan 120 balance fans for a push-pull configuration. Now adding an additional $30 and pushing things up to the $90 price point gets you the MasterLiquid 240, obviously a 240mm dual rad version of the MasterLiquid 120. And both feature Cooler Master's exclusive dual chamber pump design and are easily installed on any AM4 socket by way of the pre-existing mounts, so no fancy work here. Now this is a feature that is very, very welcome. The testing was all done on an MSI X370 X-Power Gaming Titanium motherboard with the Ryzen 7 1700 at stock and overclocked to 3.9 GHz at 1.35 volts, along with 16 GB of G-Skill FlareX DDR4 3200 memory and a Cooler Master V1200 power supply. All tests were conducted inside a MasterCase Pro 5, with both intake 140mm fans set to 1000 RPMs and a single exhaust 140mm fan set to the same 1000 RPM. And this was to represent all coolers in a more realistic working environment with the ambient temperature controlled to 22 Celsius. For stock and overclocked stress test, we used the ASUS Realbench H.264 video encoding and heavy multitasking looping for around a half hour. We wanted to test how gaming went for the overclocked chip as well, so we ran the CPU-focused benchmark for Ashes of the Singularity DX12 benchmark to see how well it coped under a core-heavy game. We let the motherboard control the fan, so we did also record where the fan speed ending up in all tests as well to test that variation. So up first on the results chart here, we have the full lineup from the Spire up to the MasterLiquid 240 at stock clocks. And of course, you can see a healthy decrease in temperatures going from the Spire all the way to the liquid cooled versions, but the 212 Evo sitting at 44.8 and the MasterLiquid 240 sitting at 42.5, if you're going stock, there's not much reason to go past, well, a simple tower air cooler. But if you move over to the fan speed, you'll see that it didn't really change a whole lot. Once you got off of stock cooling onto a custom solution, it kind of set about the same RPM all the way across the board. So that was interesting to see. So they were all really very quiet. Moving things up to an overclocked results, we see that, notice the Spire and the Max are missing from here because that 1.35 volts was just a little bit too much for it. Now this is where things start to separate, where you can see a good degree of separation between the 212 Evo and the MasterLiquid 240. The MasterAir 4 was quite impressive, to be fair, quite honest, in the fact that it did pull ahead of the MasterLiquid 120 in here. Now something to keep in consideration is something like the MasterLiquid 120 is going to eject all of the heat out of the case, whereas it's going to recirculate a little bit with the air cooling solutions in there. As far as fan speeds, they all got up to between 1750 and 1900 RPM, so not a whole lot of variation there. It's good to see. They all stay pretty much about the same sound levels. Once gaming, that's where we see the biggest variation. The MasterLiquid 240 has a substantially lower temperature while gaming than the Hyper 212 Evo. So you see if you remember the stress test numbers, you'll notice that it's a pretty big difference from there, you know, upwards to 10 degrees Celsius drop in gaming loads versus heavy stress test. And the fan curves really didn't change a whole lot. They stayed fairly similar. They dropped a little bit, but overall, good to see. So let's jump into the conclusion. Well, surprisingly, at the end of the day, all solutions performed quite well. So ultimately, it really comes down to just what you want for a cooling solution as to how hard you want to push the processor. So it's not quite the clear-cut and concise conclusion that I was hoping for, but the good thing about this is that you can see you now have plenty of options without much worry. My advice is to first decide on your budget, and then how you want things to look, and then go from there. We hope you found this video informative or entertaining, so leave us a like and subscribe, comment if you have anything to add, and this has been Keith with WCCF Tech TV, and we'll catch you all in the next video.